Hey guys, it's your girl Onana, and I welcome you all to Onana Nation. So if it is your first time on this channel, please go ahead and subscribe because we have a few topics to discuss today. First up, we're going to talk about Brenda Bia being body shamed on social media. Point number two, we're going to talk about Askia being slammed for her poor fashion sense. Point number three, we're going to talk about Mr. Leo getting an honorary award from the Minister of Arts and Culture. Point number four, we're going to talk about Sang Dilong's beautiful traditional wedding to her boo Cyril. And point number five, we are also going to talk about this African brother who found love, or should I say doggy love, in the house of an Oyibo woman. So stay tuned as we break this down. So our first topic is Brenda Bia. And for those who don't know who Brie is the daughter of President Paul Bia, President of Cameroon. So she's the first daughter of Cameroon, and because she is the daughter of a man whom most people love to hate, people tend to transfer their anger and aggression towards her father to this poor child. So people criticize her a lot on social media for everything she does. So every time she puts up a picture, people come and insult, look at your fatty knees. Every time she uploads a picture, look at your boobs are falling. Every time she uploads a picture, look at your fat bulgy eyes. Every time she uploads a picture, look at your big tummy for a little girl like you who has no kids. Like, people are nitpicking this child for every little thing she does, and sometimes I personally think it's too much. Like, if we can give her a break, she's a little girl still struggling, you know, to see what she can make of her life. But because people hate her dad so much, every little thing she does is criticized and people pour that anger into her. So Brie put this picture up just 1 hour ago, and no surprise, the picture is already getting the usual hate which her pictures always get. So this person says, "You look older than your age." Ouch, that hurts. Somebody else says, "Mem tochu fell unjansa." So people are insulting her, like she's bleaching her body, she's creaming her skin. So the post is just full of negative comment after negative comment. Look at your boobs are falling. Look at this, look at that. And people are always insulting this child for her eyes. And she's clearly telling people that I have a rare form of Graves' disease. I have a rare form of thyroid disease. That's why my eyes look the way they look. The Cameroonians don't care. They just keep insulting the child for her eyes and making meme after meme for her eyes, and it's just crazy. So this other time, she put a picture of herself in this beautiful pink crop top and pants set, and people as usual will come and insult her, you already know. So this person came, "So teo bria en grow vanch." So this person is calling the whole village, "Usa una de una kamo una kansi una fes dot I bele. Bri has a big tummy." So this other person says, "Brandy shu, même moi qui a déjà les enfants, je n'ai pas le ventre froissé comme ça. Please fais les abdos dans la paix." So this person is telling her that, "Look at your tummy. Even me who has kids, many children, my tummy is not twisted like that. Go and do abdo." So they're insulting her, and this other person says, "J'adore tes vergetures, tu es déjà une vraie femme." So they're insulting even the stretch marks that appear on her tummy. Like, they're insulting every single fiber of her being. So somebody else writes, "Voilà la fille d'un chef d'état comme toi. Après tu vas venir nous dire que tu travailles. Gros ventre." So this person is very savage. She just went and brought the picture of the first daughter of, is this Kenya or Rwanda? I forgot. So either the president of Kenya or Rwanda, one of those presidents, that's your daughter. She really has a huge following on social media. So this person went and brought the picture, like, "This is a fellow first daughter like you. See how she's doing community service for her people. She is tilting the ground, helping to clean her community. Look at you. Very soon you come and be telling us that you're working hard with your big tummy." So that person was insulting Brie, but also passing a very valid message. First daughters are actively involved in community service, but Brie doesn't do all that, and it's just a little funny. So moving on, we're going to talk about our next topic, and that will be the beautiful Askia. So Askia dropped this picture on her Facebook page, and she captioned it, "Walked in, no gun, killed everyone." Oh my gosh, I'm in love with this caption. It's so tight, it's so dope. So Askia is trying to let us know that she went to club, but she was the dappest looking in the club. She was the hottest of the night. She looked better than everyone else. And our Cameroonians, as you would expect, they came under the post insulting her. Askia, by the way, is one of the few Cameroonian artists who gets so much hate on social media. They were insulting her. "Why are you exposing all your body as a married woman?" But you guys know Askia now, she doesn't have time. She knows people hate her, and she's there to pepper them gang. So she's always giving people something to talk about. She's always giving her haters something to laugh about. So Askia uploaded this picture. She knew they were going to come for her, and they're insulting her, like, "Look at you exposing all your boobs outside. A married woman, all your boobs outside. All the time you'll be exposing your body. What is your husband saying about this?" Did her husband come and complain to you guys? Busybody people on social media, he has not complained now. So let them do what they want to do. She's a rapper, she's in the industry, she's in the entertainment business. That's how she's supposed to look, and she's supposed to give you guys things to talk about. So I don't know why you guys are dragging Asuka for no good reason. People are under the post with all kinds of insults. By the way, your fashion sense is trashy. Look at what you're wearing. Look at your ashy self. People are insulting her and stuff. And I'm just like, okay, you guys have energy. When I continue now, walk no the Cameroon. Asuka the girl when I walk. She be when I walk. When I they walk now, under her comment section, everybody is busy insulting her. And you know, as usual, she doesn't have time. So now let's move on to our next topic. Finally, something worth celebrating. Finally, something positive. Our next topic is marriage, and it's always a beautiful thing. So we have the beautiful Cameroonian actress, Body Sang, or Sang Dilong. I actually went to school with Sang. We went to the same school, Bupegza, oh yay. So she was like two or three classes ahead of me. And today she is married to her boo, Cyril. They've been dating for a couple of years now, and their relationship was never a secret. It was really open, and I'm happy for the fact that now they've decided to move it to the next step. They've decided to legalize their union, or at least traditionally at the moment. So over the weekend, Cyril took his family to Sang's family house. They asked for her hand in marriage. They paid all the traditional dues and all that, and they solidified their marriage customarily. So they are married according to their tradition, and we wish them all the best. Sang is such an amazing person. She is so funny. I love her sense of humor. So we wish you all the best, D. We love you and Cyril. And they are so cute together. I know they're going to make the most amazing babies. We wish you guys all the best in your union. Coming up next, we're going to talk about one of the Cameroonian artists which I absolutely love, Mr. Leo. So Mr. Leo is busy receiving awards in Yaoundé. Congrats to you, brother. And Mr. Leo writes, I'm just a young soul boy, born with a burning passion to impact my generation through music, inspired by the Almighty. So he further writes, special thanks to the Ministry of Arts and Culture for honoring me this day with this medal, upgrading my artistic status to Chevalier, whatever that means. I don't know, but I'm just happy for him. So our brother is in Yaoundé today, currently receiving awards and medals. You know, it's always a beautiful thing for people to recognize your hard work. So congrats to you, Mr. Leo. We are all proud of you today. Ha. And it's a serious something, though. Like, it was a really state official event. Wow. So you see representatives for the Ministry of Arts and Culture. So this white building you see here, that's the I think it's the cultural museum or something in Yaoundé. And right around this corner, there's a Ministry of Arts and Culture, there's a Ministry of Education, there's a Ministry of Women's Empowerment and the Family. Most of those ministries are around the same area in Yaoundé. So we are super proud of you, Mr. Leo. And next up, we have this guy. I don't even know who he is. I don't know where he's from. But as soon as his picture hit the internet, it went viral. Everybody and their grandma has something to say about this picture today. So that's a small African guy who just married an Oyibo woman. And it looks like the lady went all the way to Africa to marry this guy. And I'm just like, I don't understand how things like this happen in the 21st century. You would think that ladies have become smarter because guys have been using them for documents for the longest time now. So who are we to say if it's not love? It may not be Doki Oleo. It may not be Doki. It can also be love. Who are we? We don't know. So the picture hit the internet and everybody's commenting, is this love? Is this Doki marriage? Nobody knows. I'm not going to put my mouth in somebody's business. I'm not going to use my mouth and spoil somebody's gari. I'm not going to throw sand in somebody's gari, but we should be careful too. People have feelings. Don't mess with people's feelings only because you want document. Because most people marry like this and then after a few years, they abandon the ladies after getting the documents and it's not right. You're messing with people's feelings. So I don't know what their situation here is. It could be love. It could be anything. I don't know. I just thought to bring that to you guys. What do you guys think of this marriage? Is it Doki marriage? Is it love? Let me know in the comment section below. Alright guys, so with that, I guess we've come to the end of today's video. Thank you guys a lot for watching. I remain your girl Unana. And if it is your first time on this channel, please go ahead and subscribe because you definitely love it here. On this channel, we talk all things entertainment, we talk about African recipes, and we do lifestyle. So please subscribe, and you can equally share the video with your friends if you found it interesting or if you found it educative. So thank you guys a lot for watching. I equally want to thank my amazing subscribers. You guys are my motivation. You guys are my push. I thank you guys for all the support. I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. So stay safe everyone, subscribe, share the video, like, comment, tell me what you think about the topics discussed in the comment section below, and I will see you guys in my next video. Goodbye.